That was suspiciously fast. You sure it works now?
Mr. Renier, sir, we have a situation.
I'm kind of in the middle of something.
Well, it's more of an emergency, actually. Some ticks have gotten loose in the basement, and,
A what got out of what now?
It was an honest mistake. I was taking the liberty to experiment with some ticks we captured, and things got out of hand.
Mr. Jesse, before you go all red and do that angry maniac thing you do, maybe we could consider it a great opportunity.
You make it so hard to like you, Verge. You know that, right?
Remember that fortuitous gauntlet malfunction that helped you and your father survive? Turns out that that malfunction is a simple override protocol. One you can now control thanks to, well, me. You're welcome.
This better work, or there's gonna be a gauntlet malfunction on your face. I ain't got time to be cleaning up every mess you nerds make.
Please don't tell Dr. Blackwell about this. Mr. Renier?
Likely the reason you like blowing things up, Verge.
Mr. Rentier, there's some kind of havoc in the basement.
Mr. Rentier, there's an issue. I don't like this at all. The Rentiers might be the founders of the Institute, but Dr. Blackwell's the one in charge here. She asked why she can't visit your father. Lady Hall said it's your call.
Too many female doctors, but I guess you can't stop progress.
Right to be out.
This just came in. It's from Agent Gravener. Good or bad?
Private. Speaking of bad, I found a giant ancient cadaver in Baxter. Any idea why Tix would want to hide it?
A few. Why isn't Agent Bloom allowing anyone in to see your father?
Security, Doc. Calico's the last working cell in the country, and we mean to keep it that way. That means closing a few doors? Well, so be it.
But I'm a medical professional and the head of this cell.
So a chain of command shouldn't be an issue for you.
It isn't, sir.
Amelia, you don't have to get all...
I'd prefer Dr. Blackwell, sir. Ready for debrief whenever suits you best. Oh, there you are. Well, let's skip to the things we're here for, shall we? The creature you found in the Devil's Pass is essentially an oversized leech, a bloodsucker of sorts. Its stomach acids prevent blood from coagulation.
So it's like a living container?
Precisely. Moreover, according to microscopic analysis, the blood within the leech is remarkably old. It's not only that, it isn't like anything we've ever seen.
And Felicity feeds it to her familiars. Gotta learn more about that sawmill and how it's all connected.
The McCallum Sawmill was founded in 1845 by Elijah McCallum, definition of a small-town family operation. After Elijah's death 2 years ago, the mill was bought out by an investor representing the Andalusia Financial Services Group. Conglomerate of banks, oil fields, railways, you name it.
What does a big fish like that want with a shitty little sawmill on the ass end of nowhere?
It's unclear. Purchase itself was entirely above board.
What about the forest? Old native ritual sites, burial mounds, anything?
Nothing of note, no.
Well, I guess I'll just have to figure this out on my own then. Thanks for your time, Dr. Blackwell.
I live to serve, sir. I'll get back to my research now.
I have a bad feeling about this. Ooh, our zapper's acting up. The glamour must be near. Did say something about the source of the glamour. This must be it. The source. More disgusting than I even imagined. The glamour's probably secured by more of these ugly tumors. Need to take them out to destroy the illusion.
Father, I now believe there is another ancient beast we can use against our enemies. Its blood is more primitive, purer. Its birth, I believe, dates back to pre-colonial times. This is what connects us all. The source of all power resides in the blood.
Bones, blood, and these ugly critters again. It's getting weaker now. Probably there's one or maybe two sources more. Just spent thousands to take possession of this shithole, but it looks abandoned. This machinery hasn't been used for ages. Something's fishy here. Bet the answer's hidden behind that glamour. Creeps. Ooh, let's check this beauty out. There you are. I guess that was the last source. Let's see what you're hiding there.
Let's go.
Jeez, that damn smell doesn't bode well. Let's take a look-see. Christ, it's a goddamn blood factory. Not a living soul. She changed every last one of the workers here. That in this damn jungle. Source.
So, serving their crazy leech lady.
More leeches. Guess I'm on the right track.
Flourishes by feasting on its blood. It's exactly how you described it. Ancient, unique, pure. This is the missing element that'll accelerate the change. Combined with my blood, we can create a perfect progeny, bound with my will and ambition. Your life's work will be complete. They'll all see we were right to act now. If you can't change people, change the world and force them to adapt.
Protecting. Locusts. Every single tree is covered with those damn leeches.
Stay.
son of a... Another ancient beast. Fucking great. Doesn't look to be long dead. That's a hell of a tooth. A trip into its guts. Great. Thank you.
So this is where those beasts get their magical blood from. Once that ancient fella in Baxter was sucked dry, she found you, huh?
Christ, I'm starting to hate mythology.
There you are, Mr. Renty. Doc.
I know it's working, Virch, but we could sure use another one.
The technology behind those coils is so sophisticated, I'm amazed I was able to get it working. Just wait your turn.
And I thought we were friends. Why do you think I spend so much time singing your praises to Mr. Rentier?
Jesus, Martin. Cut me some slack, for goodness sake. I'm under enough pressure as it is.
Relax. I'm pretty sure he thinks I'm blowing smoke up his ass.
Anybody ever heard of a colossal monster with a forest growing on its back? Because I got some samples.
Mine.
That's a Mi'kmaq. In Huron Indian folklore, it's some kind of minor deity.
It was covered head to toe in those damn leeches.
That means we found yet another blood factory set up by Debano and Felicity.
That would explain why they attacked Baxter. They were protecting their source, the ancient blood they used to transform their familiars.
Bad news is this Mi'kmaq thing was supplying their war for quite some time now, allowing those foul bloods to spread all over the country. The good news is they won't do it anymore.
Even if he doesn't kill us in our sleep, that link in his head will lead the ticks right to us.
Then let them come. Killing ticks is what the Rentier Institute does.
You listen to yourself? This isn't about your birthright. This is what happens when we run a government agency like a goddamn monarchy. All our protocols go out the window as soon as Daddy Dearest.
Keep talking to me about the rules, you bureaucratic shrew.
Please, we're all on the same team, remember?
Only when it suits him. How about finally telling me where Edgar went?
He's in Maurepas, searching for the plant to make the regen compound.
The regen compound? Now you're wasting what little resources we have left chasing a fairy tale?
Listen, Mr. Gravener's an experienced agent. If he didn't have faith in his mission, he wouldn't bother. We are at war, Doctor. Who else is worth saving if not the leader of the Institute? And in the long run, it could help everybody if the thing by some miracle actually works.
You have until tomorrow morning. In the meantime, your father will be restrained and placed under round-the-clock supervision.
Fine. I'm gonna get Edgar's ass out of those swamps. And if I get back with that plant and I still see that shotgun in your hand, you better damn well prove you know how to use it.
You picked a strange time to assert yourself, Virgil. Why'd you back Jesse's quest for this ridiculous compound?
Just because the scientists at the manor didn't find anything doesn't mean there isn't something there. I mean, did they ever let you take a look?
No.
We have a habit at Calico of making the impossible happen, Doctor. I fixed Mr. Jesse's gauntlet, made it better even. Scott found the best lead we have with those leeches. If anyone can make that compound work, it's you.
Those are Edgar's. Must have found that planet here. Okay. The trail leads this way. Christ, wish I had a map of this place. That sounds like trouble.
I think I just improved your luck!
Something broke the boat, but it looks like you managed to escape. Must have been in a hurry if he dropped his damn crossbow. I'm sure Edgar wouldn't mind if I took advantage of this little beauty. Nothing alive here except those freaks. flesh and blood. This whole place smells like death. Jesus, who the hell would want to set up camp here?
Got through.
That's nice. Out of my way. Blood everywhere in one big ass spider web. I hate spiders.
Ash and blood. Twisted and covered with thorns. It grows only in the marshlands. They're teeth marks. Oh, it's sucked dry. Why? Some desperate soul looking for a cure? It's of no use to me now.
That eight-legged freak was hunting him down. Guess this is that giant arachnid's lair. He's not wrapped up like a mummy in a web. Guess he got away.
Thank you.
painful.
Let's stick to the facts. Bloom researched vampiric legends. A lot of myths and hoo-ha about some sort of plant. One that could allegedly reverse the process of the change. It's considered an affront to the purity of the royal blood.
Ominous. But can it work? From a biological point of view?
Now and then, some of those legends contain a grain of truth. An endemic species like this may have peculiar properties. If researched properly, some cell mutations...
Imagine how many people we could save if you made it work.
Look, I'm not a miracle worker, Virgil, but I'll give it my best shot.
I'll take that.
Almost got killed to keep that plant safe. But kept on going. That's true grit.
Used to be thick as thieves. Almost there. Ooh, didn't expect that in this damn jungle. Did you break this damn bridge, Edgar? Ah, now I need to find another way.
Doesn't look healthy. Better run quick before it sinks. Make it. Gotta be careful. Take it. Quite a find. Can't make it without a rope. Come in handy.
but don't bring this thing down on top of me.
I'll take that. More footprints. They lead to that church over there.
Suddenly get some religion.
look inviting, but let's say I trust you, Edgar.
Gotta squeeze through.
Edgar, I'm starting to doubt your navigational abilities. Cash. Ancient gates. Bad feeling about this. I'm taking it. Looks like there's only one way out of here. Edgar?
Jess, behind you!
Ah!
hurts.
Tell.
I found the plan. The locals call it La Orquídea de la Vida or something foreign like that. We get this back to Calico, squeeze it out, and maybe we have ourselves a way to turn this around.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Yeah. Getting your ass out of the fire has kind of become a habit.
Edgar, you can't keep doing this forever.
When those ticks attacked the manor, what did your father do? Run? Nah. He kept on squeezing the trigger. That's what he did. People like us don't retire, Jesse. Even if you're lucky enough to live long enough, you'll soon realize there's nothing waiting for you. There is no normal for people like me or your father. And I was naive to think there might be some normal for you. Anyway, now that just about everyone else in the Institute is dead, I figure you and your daddy are gonna need all the help you can get to build things back up again.
Well, first you give me those pretty flowers, then you get all emotional on me. Edgar, you ain't gonna try to kiss me now, are you?
You little shit.